bride-to-be Rebecca is on her way to the boutique with her all-important support network, Sister Amy, Aunt Debbie and Mum Kerry. Disappointed by a dress she'd bought online, Rebecca now has just 3 months to find her dream dress.
The dress that I've currently got isn't necessarily that bridal, I suppose. It's a bit more casual. I'm just not in love with it.
When she marries RAF technician Luke, she'll be moving 160 miles away from her family home to become a full-blown military wife.
I appreciate everything she does, and especially the fact that she's willing to drop all her family, drop everything, and move completely the opposite side of the country.
Hello, ladies. How are you? Hello.
What a pretty girl. Really, really pretty. Her eyes are amazing.
You've bought a dress already.
Yep.
This is the dress in question.
It is. When I, like, go like that, you can see a bit of bra and...
See a bit of skin. Yeah. Is that the only thing that you don't like about it?
And it doesn't fit.
Right, OK, so it's the fit as well.
Bit of an issue.
I also see you have something else under your arm.
I've got my veil in here.
Oh, this is exciting.
Do you want to see it?
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. Don't just hold the box there. We want to... Oh.
Are you going to be running through the grass, through the floor?
I don't do running.
Yeah, I don't either, you know. What if you fall in love with a dress that doesn't go with the veil? Which will win out?
I think the veil.
So she wants something quite relaxed, quite flowy, you know, not fitted and traditional. She wanted something quick and easy that she could buy offline. There's an element of, I don't want to go dress shopping because I think I might get disappointed.
Tell me, what are your top three things that's got to be in this dress?
Sleeves. I'd like it quite vintagey, I suppose, and not too blingy.
I think, Becky, you're looking for a dress that's covering you all over and you don't need to.
I don't like my arms, these bits here, and I don't necessarily like my stomach, so I wouldn't want, like, a form-fitting tight dress around here or anything. What do I like? My face. Yeah.
Listen, can't hide behind a dress. It's not the dress that's getting married, it's you.
Yeah.
So you kind of need to embrace it. It was all about bringing her hair around her face to kind of try and shield her, try to hide behind it. So that is very, very, very plain. That's a vintage...
Like that.
I knew you were going to say that. If I'm thinking about the dress that you ordered, this is probably the closest we've got.
Rebecca can feel quite self-conscious about her size. I think we all try and hide behind things that we're maybe not so confident about in our life. But for Rebecca, it's... She's done it for a long time and she's a pro at it.
What natural beauty.
Yeah.
So we might have to play it her way to start with a little bit. Let her go with what she thinks she wants, which is something to hide in.
Mm. So basically tease that confidence out quite slowly. We'll just slip her in a few fitted dresses.
I'm going to go in. I'll see you in a minute, Jo.
OK.
Right, are you ready?
I am.
Come with me. So how did you meet Luke?
We met online almost 4 years ago now. And he was at a base near mine because he's in the RAF.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
Oh.
Once we get married, we'll be moving about 3 hours away from mine.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's going to be hard for you, isn't it?
Yeah. My mum, oh, God, she's going to be devastated. She's going to be crying her eyes out probably at the end of the night. And my dad.
Are you quite ready for that sort of life? Because it's such a big
Not
thing.
Really. No. I'm quite nervous, but I'm excited. It's going to be, you know, a new chapter.
It sounds like marrying Luke is a massive change for Rebecca. She's moving away from her family. Hopefully today we can put her on the path so she has bundles of confidence moving forward.
OK, so you've all got to close your eyes.
This lacy dress is very, very similar to the style of dress that she bought originally. It just doesn't have arms on it.
OK, open your eyes.
Oh, I actually really like it.
Yeah, I like it.
I like the lace and that is, like, vintagey and... Yeah, I do like it.
Do you want to see it with the veil?
Yeah. I was kind of happy that it was too big for me, in a way. I thought, oh, that makes a change, something being too big for me.
So everyone likes this dress.
Yeah.
This is a winner at the moment.
Yeah.
There was a smile and the family did say that they liked it, but this ain't the dress for Rebecca. It's like a sleeping bag on her.
Do you want to do another?
Yeah.
Okay.
Rebecca would settle for this dress, not on my watch. Listen, you need to come out of hiding. Let's start getting some proper dresses on you, girl. You're going to own it.
I know. Oh. Yes.
This dress is nothing like she's tried on yet. It's not a casual dress. It's not a loose, flowy dress. This is a proper traditional wedding dress.
Right, stop there.
She's a beautiful girl and she's trying to find a dress that really makes her feel amazing. And up to now, she hasn't found that dress.
Next of all, I want you to open your eyes.
OK.
OK, so go on. Oh, no, you've got to open your eyes. You've got to open your eyes. Quick, everybody open your eyes.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
OK. I think it's gorgeous.
Beautiful, that is.
Beautiful.
You make it all the time.
Don't be sorry. What is this emotion?
I just didn't think that I could look
beautiful. It's beautiful.
Yeah.
Oh, pass the tissues, mate. I just felt like a bride. I felt special. I felt that I looked good. I didn't look like a fat bride in a bridal dress. I looked like a nice, normal bride in a dress.
I think you thought you couldn't wear a proper wedding dress, didn't you? And I think that's why you were thinking I'm going to go a bit more hippie.
Right, so now the real story is coming out. So you thought you couldn't have a proper wedding dress?
I just thought it'd have to be just like, I don't know, just normal, not like...
You were just going to have to settle.
Yeah.
You're a bride, that's why you're getting married, and you need to be looking and feeling like a princess. This dress is amazing. This dress is everything that she wanted, and it fits.
I don't think the veil's going to go with the dress.
I think I just need to try it on, just so that I know it either definitely doesn't go.
Rebecca still wants to try the veil on, but no, it doesn't go with this dress. Are you kidding me? This dress is enough on its own.
It cuts off at, like, a weird point, doesn't it? Mm-hmm.
I know you love that veil, but there's kind of an air of maybe that could be old Becky before she realised how bloody amazing she was.
So I then have a question for you. Would you like to put the other thing back on, or have you found your dress, do you think?
I think I found the dress.
Well...
Oh, my God! This shocked us all, this dress, didn't it?
Yeah.
Me feel very proud.
Oh. Can you be proud?
Yeah.
This is the one. I just know it's the one. I've got to have this dress. This is the one for me.
It was touch and go. She's got a dress. She's delighted.
Jo and Al have arrived from Essex, and they're keen to show Rebecca what they've made of her much-loved veil.
What a stunning venue.
Oh, the fabulous veil.
Oh, I hope she likes these. I'm sure she'll love them.
I'm sure she will.
With Rebecca, it was all about this beautiful veil that she's got. But when she came and chose her dress with us, the veil really didn't suit that style of dress. But Jo came up with a fantastic idea.
Little drawstring bags, little keepsake.
Let's just hope she likes them. Knock, knock.
Hiya.
Hello, ladies.
Hello.
Look at you all.
Thank you.
Looking all glam and calm.
Nearly glam.
This morning, nervous. I said to her, are you nervous? No, not nervous.
I think you're a little bit like a swan, you know, like all calm on the outside, but bloody inside...
I think once I get the dress on, I'll be like, oh, get married in a minute.
Right, are you ready to get married?
Yeah.
Yeah. I love Beck. I love that she's so caring and she's so down to earth and relaxed. So I want our future together to be full of love and happiness.
I've been dreaming of my wedding day since I was about 5. I absolutely love him to bits. I am definitely living out my dream.
I, Luke, do take the Rebecca to be my lawful wedded wife.
Promise to care for you.
Support and comfort you.
And respect and cherish you.
Throughout our lives together.
You are now husband and wife.